unit. For the Sea Basin Strategies, Maritime Regional Cooperation and Maritime Security, at the Director General of Maritime Affairs and Fisheries for the European Commission. Thank you, Christos.
Thank you, and good morning to everybody. I think as the head of unit dealing with maritime cooperation and sea basin strategies, definitely we have a few things to tell you. I will try to respect the time and certainly show how the maritime regional cooperation is very much in the origin of not only creating policies but also opportunities and bringing together the stakeholder community that this program is trying also to do. And at the end of the day, I think policy makers and business research institutions have to work closely to implement these actions that are designed in places like this one. And definitely we do this part in the European Commission because we have tried to promote cooperation, first of all, in a very broad area. When we talk about sea basins, we look into areas beyond national borders. Particularly for the blue economy, it's something which cannot be handled when we try to develop common actions at national level. Therefore, regional cooperation is at the origin of many of our policies. This one particularly, when we look into the Mediterranean, we have promoted overall cooperation between Mediterranean countries through the UFM, first of all. The UFM has, since 2015, agreed on actions under a ministerial declaration, promoting particularly the blue economy. And we are implementing this together with the with the countries, with the regions, with the instruments that the EU and the countries have put together. I mean, Interreg has definitely worked in that line. What we have brought to the countries with this cooperation, first, a structural dialogue, because we should not forget that these countries need this to promote common projects, common ideas. When we established the so-called Blue Economy Working Group, this doesn't exist as a structure. This is a place where the countries learn from each other, create the clusters, create the conditions for the stakeholders to come together. Then we also, through this declaration, through this ministerial, the impact of the ministerial agreement 2015, we advanced with the West Mediterranean Initiative, which brought together 10 countries from the western part of the Mediterranean, and we are currently working for developing projects, concrete priorities, and I think this also is reflected into the way the Interreg is planning its future actions. So you refer to security, surveillance. This is among the things that the Western Mediterranean is working, and also bringing together clusters. This is also the other way that the Western Mediterranean is promoting, and we have already results, like about 10 million have also been projects have been funded under the umbrella of the Western Mediterranean. And it is only a very recent initiative, a year, and now we are in the second year of implementation. Now, I already referred to a specific sea basin initiative. There is another one in the Mediterranean which involves the Adriatic and Ionian sea basin. This is a macro-regional strategy involving 8 countries, EU and non-EU, in the area. And although it is framed under the macro-regional framework, which is obviously my colleagues in DG Regio are in the lead, It has a very strong blue economy and maritime dimension. So when you talk about tourism, when you talk about blue economy, when you talk environment, connectivity, these are all things that are implementing the common actions for promoting a sustainable blue economy. It is, of course, I need to add one other dimension, the research. The innovation is behind a lot of the actions we like to promote, whether we talk about sustainable blue economy sectors or activities or even the connectivity element I mentioned, the surveillance and all that. There we are benefiting from funds coming from the Horizon 2020 and the dedicated program, the BlueMed program, which also brings together communities. Now, it also concerns not only the EU countries, but the partner countries from the south of the Mediterranean. And it creates these conditions, bringing the communities together, help them to communicate and come up with ideas and participate to, let's say, the projects that you are also trying to put together. I would like to conclude by saying the same thing with which I started. When we are creating the conditions at the policy level, we are also accompanying them. So it's not that we only write the action plans and then we relate everything to the nature. So we are following very closely the work of the programs. We follow very closely the work of the countries. We are present in promoting with future activities. And actually, it's, I think, worthwhile to note that in the mission statement of our commissioner designate, so under the new commission, we will then have to develop a new approach for sustainable blue economy, including the maritime regional cooperation and the sea-based services. So our work will continue, and I'm sure we will share much more events like this and much more, let's say, results to advertise. Thank you very much.